Let us discuss about the pressure distribution in a closed accelerated container. In previous section, we already discussed that in an open container, when it is accelerated, the free surface of liquid get inclined with the horizontal depending on the acceleration of container. Say if we are having a completely closed container which is enclosing a fluid, and say container is accelerating with an acceleration A. Here we can say all the layers of fluid will incline to the horizontal with the same acceleration, with the same angle theta, which is given as tan inverse of A by G, which we have earlier calculated. Or this is the angle which all the layers will make with the horizontal within the fluid. Now, in such a situation, there is no part of a fluid which is exposed to atmosphere. So, if we wish to find out the least pressure point, it can be taken at top right corner of the container. In this situation, we can say this is the least pressure point in the fluid body which is enclosed in the container, because from this point only pressure will start increasing as G effective is acting in this direction because of the resultant effect of pseudo acceleration and the gravity G, and this angle is same as theta. Now in such a situation, say we wish to find out pressure at point A, which is at a depth H below the top surface of the container and at a distance L from the front surface of the container, then here we can calculate it in either of the three ways which we have discussed in the previous section. But the best way out is successive increment in pressure. Like we can consider the least pressure point pressure will be zero. So if we wish to find out pressure at this point, which is at a depth H below this point, so we can say pressure at this point will be 0 plus H rho G. And if we are having pressure at this point pressure can be written as this plus L rho A, as pseudo acceleration is acting in this direction. So along the horizontal line, pressure difference will only be due to the pseudo acceleration. And this is the pressure at point A. So, using such equations, we can directly write down the pressure at A, which can be written as H rho G plus L rho A. So, just be careful whenever you wish to find the pressure at a point, it can be obtained by writing the equation of successive increase in pressure from one point to another, then another to final destination where pressure is required. Same equation can be written by moving along this path. First, say if here we consider pressure to be 0. Pressure at this point can be written as 0 plus L rho A, as along the length of L pressure is only varying due to A. And now if we know the pressure at this point, pressure at point A can be written as this is the pressure 0 plus L rho A plus, due to a vertical depth H, pressure will only vary due to gravity, so it will be H rho G. You can see the same result we are getting no matter which path we are following.